I'm assuming that I'm not the only one that was having this problem or is still having this problem. I had a series of dreams over a period of a week before I went on my break with my grandchildren and my daughter. You know, I've talked with you about the imp that most of us deal with from time to time. He jumps up on your bed in the times that you are so tired or you're ill, and he tries to convince you that you are not a Christian. And then he starts bringing up a list of things that you've done in your past. And he's just a little naggy imp. Well, this is one that talks to you when you're awake, that I'm talking, the imp is. But this dream, reoccurring dream that I had over a period of a week, may have been longer than a week. This was a demon, a spirit. He came into my dream in the beginning. He was like a judging spirit, because you know, demonic spirits, demons, whatever, they're all the same, whatever you want to call them. He was a ruling spirit because they have levels of, in their army, just like in the army of the Lord. He was a judging, ruling spirit. He came into my nighttime, and I'm always tired at night because I just can't stop. Even when I worked, I was a workaholic. I worked until there was nothing left in me. So I'm exhausted when I go to bed every night. So I would go to sleep. The minute I hit my bed, it felt like I would fall into a deep sleep. And this demonic ruling spirit would come into my dream, and it seemed as if he was dealing with me all night long. And I don't normally tear my bed covers off, but this whole week I did. One night I woke up and my pillow was tossed all the way across my bedroom. My bedroom's pretty good sized. So when I woke up, I was like, where in the world is my pillow? He had a list. And he would not let me go. He brought up every sin, because I've told you I was never Miss Goody Two Shoes. Anyone that tells you they are, because you sin in deed or in thought all the time. I don't care who you are. No one's perfect. Jesus Christ said no one's perfect, no one but the Father. Remember that. I don't care who you are. You're a liar if you say you've never sinned. But I was never Miss Goody Two Shoes. But this spirit had a big list. He went way back into my teens, early teens. On this list, he was naming every sin that I've ever committed, even the tiny ones. But he would hammer the big ones. And, you know, I've told you that the Lord doesn't view the big, there's a big sin in your life, there's a little sin in your life, and then there's a little teeny, weeny sins. No, they're all sins to him. Sin is sin. But he hammered at me just all night long and just would not let me go. And he just, how about this sin? How about this sin? How about that sin? It seemed like a whole week or longer. And toward the end of that week, even in my waking hours, he badgered me. And I was just like, there was no getting away from this demonic spirit. I mean, he was in my face. And I was just like, oh my gosh, I can't get away from you. And then all of a sudden I was like, wait a minute, what sins? Every one of those were in my past. They are forgiven. Who do you think you are? And the minute I said that out loud, he vanished. He never came back. He's never bothered me since that time. I said, who do you think you are? Those are in the past. Those are forgiven. It was like, he tormented me so bad I forgot. I have authority over him, and those are forgiven. You know, when the little imp would come, when I didn't feel good, and was, yeah, 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 who do you think you are? I didn't have no problem with him, except I was usually had fever or I was so tired. I just, you know, wanted to bat him away, and I took authority over him. But this one, I'm just telling you, he was just, oh, he was overbearing. To the point I couldn't think, because I knew I committed all those sins. But in heaven, they're not on the records. If you went before the Lord and you said, did you forgive me of those sins? He'd say, what sins? They're not on the books. I don't know what you're talking about. Because the Father forgave them, and they'll be blotted off the book. And so when I said that, the minute I said that, the Holy Spirit, the Father spoke to me. And he said, there's coming. This is the most important. I know that there's other people going through this right now because I'm not the only one that's being bothered. I can't be. But the Father spoke to me and he said, you have to overcome this spirit and get him under your feet where he belongs. Because there's coming greater spirits on the face of the earth that no one's ever dealt with before. You need to find out who you are and walk in your authority, or you will not be able to handle. And I'm not saying this to put fear in anyone. I'm saying this because you need to find out who your authority. You need to walk in it, or you'll be crushed. And you'll walk in fear. And we're not supposed to walk in fear. Fear not, he said. Many times in the Bible, and I've talked about this so many times, in many videos. Fear not, for I am with you. But you are supposed to take authority over demonic forces, for greater is he that's in us than he that's in this world. He is not of confusion. So if you're walking around in confusion, wondering what in the world's going on, you know right then that's not him. That is a demonic force is coming against you. So when these demonic forces come up on this earth and you walk in confusion and you walk in fear, oh, wait a minute, you know that right there is not of God. What do we do? Number one, we need to get in worship. That'll make them get away from you. They don't want to be in his presence. No, no, no. So then you can get back on your feet and get them under your feet and you walk in your authority. Because when you're walking in the authority, you look like Christ and they don't know who you are. You or him. Get your armor on. You are Jesus Christ. Walk in your authority or they're going to smash you. I had to share this because I know that there's some people out there that are already being smashed by this ruling spirits. And you're wondering, am I really saved? Am I really born again? Am I really filled with the Holy Spirit? Or did I just think I was speaking in other tongues? Because confusion has come and fear has snuck in. Shake it off. Be who you are called in Christ. And tell that demonic spirit to get out. Take your authority. And be who you are called. And walk in it. Walk in it.